I mean, yeah, from the peer you hear from.
But I know if you want to focus on music, it's a good idea to have that background. Like, we have a friend who's really interested in music, so he, at least gonna minor, I don't know if he's gonna major, but he, that's really important for him. So it's important for him to go to level 10, pass. Personally, I think it was good to get that music theory experience and just music experience in general. Colleges, they kind of understand that a lot of Chinese people will play piano. So I feel like the college admissions like see that and they kind of just not, they will dismiss it because they know it's a good accomplishment in itself, but it doesn't weigh as strongly as other factors could.
I just have a quick question. Okay. Did you guys get any academic support from SUMA or ELE for SAT prep or SAT?
I worked with SUMA for SATs.
You did.
But I would say you can accomplish the things that they that I accomplished there just self studying.
I think SUMA is mostly good for having a schedule for your kids because
exactly.
Over the summer no one wants to actually work, so if you have to go to class, you have to do the homework, you have to show up. It's really nice to actually get that practice in instead of just pushing it to the next day or the next month or the next.
Yeah,
so
I'd say it just, it's good for forcing you to get the work done. But
you guys
can do
are
all
self-motivated,
work
so you guys probably didn't need to.
Huh?
I have two questions. One is how many APs you took in the 4 years? The second question is that what is the leadership role you have been taking in this way to demonstrate?
I'd say, well, first of all, yeah, I think we already addressed the AP question, but it's, I'd say that number isn't necessarily that important, in that I can tell you that I took like 15 or 16 APs, but that really, you should not be shooting for a goal number of APs. Getting two or three extra APs is not worth, necessarily worth the time commitment when you could be doing extracurriculars that colleges value more. And as for leadership roles, I'd say I know some individuals, I'm not going to say any names, but pretty much all they do is they go, make a club, make themselves president, and then they don't do anything with the club. And that's really, I really dislike that because, well, colleges know that people do that too. Because of that, they don't really, if they see, oh, club president, they don't really care that much as, unless there's also results associated with you being the president. So they, so I'd say, yeah, you want maybe a president leadership position or two, but you also want to develop and show that you've actually done something with that role.
How about Kathy?
I agree with Eric. It's kind of empty to just create a club. One of my most main leadership roles, I'd say, was Poli Science Olympiad. That's pretty much what I'm taking. Though a lot of that was easier for me because I got to like export a lot of it to the parents. Which was nice. Yeah, I think really leadership is in terms of what you actually do with it instead of just having that name in itself.
Okay, yes, question.
I think you have been here a while. Did you guys take Spanish?
I took Spanish 1 and 2 and then stopped.
I took French.
So after the pre-calculus, you took calculus AB or BC?
BC. Calculus AB is very similar to pre-calc, especially at SEC and TP. And then it's like AB and BC overlap also a bit. So in the end, taking pre-calc and BC, if you're up for it and you feel like you can actually go on without the extra review, it's probably better than just going through AB as well.
What I did is actually skip pre-calc, so I did AB and then BC. But
but
I would say it's not worth skipping the class if you feel much more comfortable just taking all three.
Right.
Do you have any other interests?
Other than what?
Science.
Other than science? I know Catherine does speech and debate. As I said, I'm a fencer actually devote a pretty big amount of time to that. She's very obsessed with card games.
There's like the fun side and there's also the academic side. So on the fun side, I like reading, I like card games, etc. Puzzles. On the academic side, like you said, I did debates, which was actually really nice because I kind of like debate in itself as an idea, and then it really gave me the chance to explore like more of the humanities, like current events side rather than just science, because debate mostly focuses on policies, and I got the chance to explore that because normally I wouldn't really pay much attention to that. I also started linguistics, which was really interesting for me. I like languages in general, and then linguistics is kind of more like the study of language as a whole, like how language works and how it's put together, and etymology and all that stuff. So that would, I'd say, be, I'm probably going to minor in linguistics.
So you can write Chinese too, right? You both?
Do you both take AP Chinese here?
I actually didn't get to go to the AP level, but I took Chinese here.
Yeah, I didn't either.
Just the Chinese 1, 2, 3, 4?
I'm actually self-studying AP Chinese this year because I found that I can't make it. Oh, I have so many other commitments, I can't necessarily.